me about our future and the industry and what you're looking for, Douglas. Any pointers?
Well, I think probably you know butchers are looking for smaller carcasses. They're not looking for huge rumps anymore. They're looking for muscle that's even all the way down. They're not looking for huge shoulders with a dip behind them. They're looking for something that's nice, uniform shape. We're not looking for anything too big. I hate to think the amount of bone that might be on number six. Because you're looking for something that's a bit nearer the ground than that. Because you've got to pay for these bones anyway.
Yeah, but we're not getting into breeds here, Douglas.
I'm not talking about that, all right.
We're getting into breeds.
Okay, I'm talking about looking for something that's going to come out a U4RL.
Really?
And butchers are not afraid to pay a price for the right thing.
Yeah. So, what we're saying is, now some folk have already chipped me here and said, well, wait a minute, I'm only paid on 400 kilos or 360 kilos, and I'm only paid on a UR and R grade. But remember, the future very much dictates that you may move away from that. As you well know, in many of the abattoirs now, you've got your VIA systems, video, image, analysis. They're paying you a grade at the moment, but probably their full intention is just like an Australian and American system, where they're actually paying you on the yield of all your different cuts. So if you've got more sirloin, you're paid them more than that. If you've got more fillet, you're paid them that. So you're actually paid on the different cuts, and that's going to make a big difference for us. Again, going back to where our length is and our width is, paid for what we produce and not just an overall yield. It's the different cuts that are important for us. But at the sirloin rump or that, we must get cattle ready for what we're doing, but still we need to keep being efficient. Dead weight limits. We need to drive efficiency quicker, earlier, cost effective, and not just breed cattle for the sake of it. Because what's also important to remember is we have the dairy industry here today. And as the dairy industry are now moving to about 20% of their cows using sex semen, they're now able to bring beef bulls into the herds. And their beef bulls, they need to be buying bulls again, not just on growth, that'll have that length that we're looking for and will have the right carcasses. Because really, to be quite honest, a lot of our beef in the future will very much will come from the dairy industry. So that's what we're looking at today, and that's what we're trying to go over. And so what I would like to do is just summarise and say thanks very much for attending. Thank you.